This is a quick tip of how to create a cut line for this vector artwork. So this is a pure vector artwork. You see a lot of single elements, and we want to have a line running around it so you can cut it with your plotter and make stickers. You know me, I'm a big fan of the appearance panel, and of course you can do it with appearances, but you need this path in the end. So appearances won't get you that far. So how can we proceed to get this quick and dirty? First of all, let's select all of this and group it. Now, in case there are live elements in it, like brushes or effects that you want to keep, then you should make a copy of this, because we will expand a lot of it. So now, in order to get our cut line, go to Effect, Stylize, Drop Shadow. Now, you see the result. Nothing could be farther from a cut line with all this softness. How on earth could this get us closer to it? Now, let's take a look at the blur and set it to 0. And you see, well, that's a nice line that follows the shape exactly. But drop shadow is a pixel-based effect, so how can that work? Well, unless you set the blur to 0, then it's not pixel-based. And of course, we need to set these two to 0 as well, so it's placed exactly below the shape. Great. Now, this is a live effect, so let's expand it. Object, expand appearance. And then let's inspect this. You see, in the layers panel, we've got a group with two groups inside. Let's first ungroup this, and then let's go into here again, move this on top, and you see, that's nice. I'm going to hide the bottom. So we see this, and you see there are quite some holes inside of here. And also when we go into outline view, now this won't work for cutting. So what we need to do is go to object expand, because there are still live strokes in it and we need to get rid of them. Let's go to OK. And then in the Pathfinder panel, hit unite. That looks better. And in outline view, this is quite nice. But there are still holes in it. And also, if you look at it in the layers panel, you see there's a group and a compound path. And let's get rid of that. So let's ungroup this and then make a compound path like so. We need this because we need some padding between the shapes and the cut line. So when something doesn't fit really, then we still have the padding and everything looks nice and the cutter won't cut into the print. So just like that. And in order to get that, we're going to turn on this again, and then we need to flip fill and stroke like so. And let's set this stroke to something like this, cyan, and then let's make the padding. Let's go to Effect, Path, Offset Path, and let's set the offset slightly lower and set this to round, which gives us some nice round corners. And we've got all these waves in there, and maybe that's not quite what we need. So let's get this away so we get some really nice shapes. But it's quite large. We will be getting there. So next thing is, let's add another offset path effect. Okay, and let's reduce this like so, and another one with the round and you see all these ridges that have been there before are now gone, and we get some nice smooth lines in here. Let's go to OK. And the only thing you need to do now is again go to Object, Expand Appearance, and there we have the path, which can now be used as a cut path. Of course, you need to apply all the colors or names or stroke weights that you need for your plotter, and you need to check the documentation because it will tell you all these things, what you need to apply there.